Classification of cell on the basis of shape, size and number. So students, you all know that cells are too small which we cannot see with our naked eye. We can see these kind of cells only under a microscope. You can see different shapes and sizes of cells under a microscope. But there are some cells which are surprisingly large in size and which we can see with our naked eye. That is egg of hen. Egg of hen is also the example of cell. So, on the basis of this, cells are classified into three types. Shape, size and number. So, let's discuss first shape of cell. Different types of cells have different types of shapes as well. So, let's see one by one. All living organisms contain cells of different shapes. For example, amoeba, which is unicellular organism, has no definite shape. You can see here, amoeba, which is unicellular organism, has no definite shape. It keeps changing its shape. Projections of various lengths produce out of the body of the amoeba. You can see here the projections. These are the projections, which is also called as pseudopodia. Pseudo means false and podia means feet. These false feet or the pseudopodias or the projections help the amoeba to move and capture its food. In multicellular animals, different cells have different shapes. The shape of a cell is determined by its own function. So let's see different shapes of different cells. You can see here smooth muscle cell and bacterial cell. Smooth muscle cell is spindle shape and that is long and pointed at both the ends. Then bacterial cell. Bacterial cells have many shapes. It may be spherical, it may be elongated, it may be oval shape or rod shape. You can see here all the shapes of bacterial cells. Then nerve cell. Nerve cells or neurons have many branches. You can see here the branches of nerve cell. Nerve cells or neurons have many branches and thus these cells helps in the transfer of messages throughout the body and thus helping in the controlling of entire body. Then WBCs and RBCs. You can see here WBC white blood cells and RBCs red blood cells. You can see here both the cells, RBCs and WBC in this image. Red blood cells are round spherical disc-like structures and white blood cells are only the cell in human body which can change their shape. So this is all about the classification of cell on the basis of shape. The size of the cells varies across the organism. Some cells of living organism can be seen with the naked eye like hen's egg and other cells in living organism can be very microscopic and cannot be seen with the naked eye as we have already discussed. They need to be enlarged or magnified by microscope. In bacteria, the smallest cell amongst all the cells is PP yellow, that is pleuropneumonia-like organism or mycoplasma. And the size of PP yellow is 0.1 to 0.5 micrometers. And the largest cell amongst all the cell is egg of ostrich. The size of ostrich egg is about 7 to 9 inches. So, the smallest cell amongst all the cell is PP yellow, that is pleuropneumonia-like organism and the largest cell is ostrich egg. So, this is all about the size of the cell. After size, let's see classification of cell on the basis of number. On the basis of number, there are two types of organisms. One is unicellular. And other one is multicellular. Unicellular, uni means single. So, the organism made up of a single cell, it is called as unicellular organism. For example, bacteria, protozoa, amoeba are the unicellular organisms. Then multicellular. Multi means many. The organism which are made up of many cells or more than one cell are called as a multicellular organism. Examples are plants, animals, and humans. These are the example of multicellular organisms. So this is all about unicellular and multicellular organisms. But student, you all know that each multicellular organism starts its life as a single cell, which is fertilized egg. The fertilized egg cell then multiplies and the number of cells increases, and thus a multicellular organism with a billion of cells is formed. So, unicellular organism can capture and digest their food, excrete, grow and reproduce. They can perform all necessary functions that multicellular organisms perform for survival. And multicellular animals carry out the specialized function with the help of groups of specialized cell called tissue, which in turn form organs and organ systems. Types of cells. So student, all cells are broadly classified into two types. Which are these types? One is prokaryotes and other one is eukaryotes. So, prokaryotes were the only form of life on the earth for millions of years until more complicated eukaryotic cells came into existence. So, prokaryotic cells are very old cells, oldest cells, and eukaryotic cells which are evolved from prokaryotic cells, which we have already discussed in introduction of cell, that any unicellular organism starts its journey from a single cell. All unicellular organisms includes in prokaryotes as they do not have nucleus, and all multicellular organism includes in eukaryotes as they contain nucleus inside the cell. The example of unicellular organisms. The example is bacteria, which includes in prokaryotes and which do not contain any type of nucleus in the cell. And the example of eukaryotes are the example of multicellular organisms, which includes in eukaryotes are plants and animals. The structure of plant cell and animal cell we will discuss a little later, but first we are going to discuss the structure of bacterial cell as an example of prokaryotic cell. First we are going to discuss the structure of bacterial cell and basic structure of eukaryotic cells. So let's discuss one by one. Here you can see the structure of prokaryotic cell or bacterial cell. Let's see the meaning of prokaryote, where pro means before and kary means nucleus. We have already discussed that prokaryotic cells are ancient cells, and these cells are very simple in structure as unicellular. These cells are very simple as they do not have nucleus and they have very few specialized organelles. So let's discuss the basic structure of bacterial cell. You can see the bacterial cell with the organelles. Bacterial cell consists of three basic layers, which is very important. First layer is plasma membrane, which separates inner side environment from outside environment. Then cell wall. Cell wall protects the cell from its surroundings. And last one is capsule, which protects the cell from desiccation under any adverse condition. These three layers are very important and called as protective layers. So, the inner side compartment of bacterial cell is filled with the fluid which is called as cytoplasm. Cytoplasm is 80% liquid and usually colorless. Then, You can see nucleotide over here. The chromosome along with the several protein and RNA molecule form an irregular structure which is called as nucleotide. And this nucleotide is present inside the cytoplasm. Some small circular DNAs are also present inside the cytoplasm, which is separated from basic chromosomal DNA, are called as plastid. Bacterial cell contain two strains. If plasmids are present in bacterial cell, then bacterial cell is of positive strain. And if plasmids are absent, then the bacterial cell is of negative strain. Some non-membranous bodies are scattered inside the cytoplasm, which is called as ribosomes. You can see long thread-like structure attached to the bacterial cell, which is called as flagellum and which helps bacterial cell for movement. There are many small thread-like structures also, which is called as pili. Pili is a thin rigid fiber which is made up of a protein and also called as a fimbri. The primary function of these pili are to attach a bacterial cell to the specific surfaces or to other cells. So, this is the basic structure of bacterial cell. Then let's discuss eukaryotes, eukaryotic cell, basic structure of eukaryotic cell. Where eu means true and kary means again nucleus. You can see here the basic structure of eukaryotic cell where nucleus is present and inside the cytoplasm many specialized organelles are present because of which eukaryotic cell is called as complex cell. So this is all about the basic structure of eukaryotic cell. All these specified organelles we are going to discuss in our next topic, that is plant cell versus animal cell. We have discussed the basic structures of prokaryotic cells and eukaryotic cells. Now let's discuss the difference between prokaryotic cell and eukaryotic cell. The difference between prokaryotic cell and eukaryotic cell is most important difference among all groups of organisms. So let's discuss one by one. Prokaryotic cells are most ancient cells. As we have already discussed that prokaryotic cells were the only form of life on the earth until more complicated eukaryotic cells came into existence. And hence prokaryotic cells are most ancient cells and eukaryotic cells evolved from prokaryotic cells. Prokaryotic cells are very small in structures and due to this they can reproduce very quickly. Where eukaryotic cells are comparatively large. Nucleus is absent in prokaryotic cells as all unicellular organism includes in prokaryotic cell which do not contain nucleus. The genetic material which is present inside the cytoplasm is without any nucleus. And in case of eukaryotes, nucleus is present. Prokaryotic cells are very simple as they have very few organelles. And eukaryotic cells are very complex as they have many organelles in the cell. So this is all about the difference between prokaryote and eukaryote. Now let's see the similarities between both the cells. Both cells contain genetic material which is called as DNA. Both cells contain plasma membrane. Both cells contain non-membranous structure which is called as ribosomes. And the inner side compartment of both the cells are filled with cytoplasm. So these are the similarities of both the cells.